Well, the Birdland neighborhood up near 2nd Avenue may be the main area of concern. Two other neighborhoods further downstream, Indianola Hills and McKinley, Columbus, are dealing with big problems right now. News Channel 8's Carrie Gavin's just back from a community meeting tonight. She continues our teammate coverage.
Stacy, residents in that area aren't dealing with river or rainwater in their homes, but sanitary sewage.
And I can't handle this anymore.
More than 60 Southeast Side residents gathered at the meeting to get answers and express their concerns. Residents like Justin Bald are frustrated about the sewer backup they continue to see in their homes.
What about down here? Look at our houses and our streets, and you know, maybe they should consider us a little bit better.
While the city is dealing with the threat of flooding, Public Works Director Bill Stowe says they're also trying to address the issue of sewers backing up. It's an issue that continues to be fueled by the amount of water that's in the river system.
We're really concerned that we continue to have a high water table in Des Moines, which means sewers are generally full. Whether they're old or new, unfortunately, we just have a lot of water still coming into the sewers.
The wastewater treatment plant treats both sanitary sewage and combined sewage for 450,000 customers in the metro. The plant has reached its capacity twice in the past week.
When we have this much groundwater, the plant is maxed out, basically. We can't get water through there quickly enough, and so it moves more slowly through the pipes. There's external rain, and voila, and unfortunately, it comes up in people's basements.
With more rain in the forecast, residents fear that their basements will be flooded with sewage once again.
I want to walk away. That's what I want to do. I want to walk away from my home.
City officials suggested that residents at the meeting tonight apply for the Private Property Protection Program. That's a program that's through the city. It provides a subsidy reimbursement of up to $1,000 to eligible homeowners to have a sump pump or backwater valve installed. The city is also awaiting federal approval to start a project that would move water through the wastewater treatment plant more quickly. That's expected to be completed in the next 3 years.
Carrie Gavin, thank you.